Okay, so we are starting exemption. We had initiated exempted services in last lecture. Just allow me to show you goods which are exempted from services, exempted from GST. We don't have to focus much on goods. Okay, in examination usually services comes, alright, and services are complicated to remember. Goods are just like you have to go through the list once or twice, that's enough. So some random goods I'm going to pick up for exemption. These are exempted goods column and that is exempted service column. Service we are going to discuss in detail. Focus on exempted goods column, this side column. Okay, so right now we are focusing on exempted goods column, so allow me to zoom it in some extent. Okay, so this is notification number 2/2017 CTR dated 28th June 2017. We are talking about live animals other than live horses. So horses, other than horses, all other animals are exempted. So therefore a chicken vendor or goat vendor doesn't charge any GST on that. Okay, meat, edible meat, fish, exempt, dairy product exempt, so you can understand all milk and all, butter, everything is exempt. Then human hair, people do sell human hair, that is also exempt. Semen, frozen semen is also exempt. Don't ask me why to buy that and all, okay, that is your call. Live trees, other plants, bulbs, roots, okay, cut flowers, exempt. Then we are having edible vegetable roots, okay, tubers, so potatoes, onions, cabbage, cauliflower, whatever we get in vegetable market is exempt. It's not exhaustive list, lastly they are writing, etc. You can understand, therefore it cannot be exhaustive law, okay. So the list, just for your reference, we have to go through it, otherwise it's not even required. All fruits and all nuts, they are exempt, okay. Next, coffee beans are exempt, cereals are exempt, then product of milling industry is exempt. We are having oil seed, fruits, food grains, seeds, that is also exempt, lac, gum, that is exempt. So just you just have to read the way I am reading it. There is no explanation why is it exempt, why that is exempt, it's not like that. Plus vegetable planting materials, vegetable products, sugar exempt. Next, flour exempt, milk exempt, puffed rice is exempt. Puffed rice, you know, poha. Poha and this. Papad exempt, bread exempt, prasadam exempt. In temple they sell prasadam, no? Yes. Laddu and all, that is exempt. Vinegar water exempt, certain beverages are exempt. Waste from food industry is exempt, salt exempt, sulfur exempt, earth and stone, plastering material, lime and cement is also exempt. Pharmaceutical products, human blood is component, component means that, you know, white cells and all, platelets, that is also exempt. Organic manure exempt. Then these are the certain thing that we use as the rituals, okay, kumkum, bindi, sindoor, alta, I don't know what is that, okay. Plastic articles, plastic bangles exempt, okay. So this was given in our module also. Rubber articles thereof, condoms and contraceptives are exempt. Woods, article wood, okay, articles of wood, that is also exempt. Printed book, newspaper, pictures and other product of printing industry, they are also exempt. Therefore, when you buy newspaper, there is no GST on it. Hello. This you need to learn by daily practices. You, whenever you buy something, you need to check whether GST is charged or GST is not charged. Okay. You just have to observe. Okay. And when you are observing, you need to understand, okay, here they are not charging GST. That means it should be exempt. Okay. So this is how you need to understand. Coconut and jute fiber, some item, more items are exempt. Textile articles are exempt. Ceramic products are exempt. You know, ceramic products, that tiles and all, they make. glass wheel are exempt, bangles are exempt, except those which are made with precious metals. That means if you are making bangle with gold, hello, then it is taxable. Okay. Tools, implements, cutlery, spoons, forks. These are the like item that we usually use in home for dinner set and all. That is also exempt. Nuclear reactors are exempt. Machinery and mechanical appliances and part thereof. Handloom is also exempt. Aircraft, spacecraft and part thereof. That is also exempt. So aircraft is exempt. Photographs, the cinematographic, that is also exempt. Indigenous handmade musical instrument are exempt. You know, some handmade musical instrument they make. Okay, that is also exempt. Slate pencils, chalk sticks, that is also exempt. Then we have project import, laboratory chemicals, that is also exempt. So these 43 entries are there, not that important. Okay, read it 2-3 times. I don't know whether it will come in exam or not. I believe it should not come. Okay, but just because it is there, we have to go through it. Okay, you don't have to put lot of brain and energy into it. Right now we are starting with exempted services, which is that side. Okay, this is important. Again, when I say important, there are more than 85 entries, and that too amended again and again. Okay, because it is amended, I can't teach you again. Something which is amended, I can't teach you from your module. So I have to take help of CA Institute module. Alright. So I am teaching you from CA Institute module, but you people are following CMA module. Alright. So you can just, you know, keep amending entry numbers. So these are the entry numbers. Okay. You understand? No, these are the entry numbers. Entry at 35. Okay, so I will be teaching you through entry numbers. You check which entry I am on, okay, and check whether it is amended in your book or not, and then you cross refer. I will be teaching you directly from CA module now, okay, because I don't have time to teach old law and new law. I am directly teaching you new law. Okay, so these are the statutory provisions. Central government is drawing this power from section 11, and by using this power, government have issued notification number 12, and we are going to read notification number 12 and entries of notification number 12. Okay, here also you can see our institute had given only this much examples. Okay, and that too with image, because they thought maybe CA student don't know how potato looks like. so potatoes are there, milk is there, life fish is exempt, grapes are exempt, Indian national flag exempt. So for one example in future to teach you certain things, I need this example that Indian national flag is exempt. Bangles are exempt, okay. And our institute is very simple, okay. They say student may go through the complete list of goods exempted from GST on GST website for knowledge purpose. Not for examination purpose, not for syllabus purpose. If you want to gain knowledge which items are exempted, you have to go to website of CBIC. Am I clear? This is how they have written. Very safe game. Okay. Last lecture, we had started discussion on charitable institution, and we completed our discussion on charitable institution. Okay. I told you a lot of charitable institutions are there in India. Okay. Charitable activities are getting conducted. They need not to be for free. Sometimes there is a consideration. Although the activity is charitable, but there will be some consideration. That consideration need not to have GST implication. Alright. So charitable activities conducted by charitable trust are exempt. And that trust must be registered under section 12AA of Income Tax Act. Therefore, Income Tax Act will have control over it. Okay, this is what we have discussed. I'm just taking as a revision. Then I told you in India we are having temples, gurudwaras, churches where lot of religious ceremonies are conducting. Okay, and then there are pandit or priest, hello, or molia, whoever is like authority there, they conduct certain activities, and for conducting activity they charge money. They don't do it for free. Alright, so if it is a religious ceremony, then it is exempt. They will not take GST on it. Hello, so Panditji will just do the puja, he will not, and he will take only 5,000, 10,000, whatever is his fees, he will not charge GST on it because Panditji are exempt here. Okay, next, renting of that princict, renting of princict is also exempt, but these three numbers we have kept in mind. If it is a Kalyana Mandapam or that open place or hall, religious hall for religious ceremony, then, and if they are charging up to 9,999 per day, then only exempt. If they are charging 10,000 or more, then it will become taxable. If there are rooms provided by this religious precinct, all right, rooms where you can go and stay and you can change your clothes, take bath and go to temple. So for that they provide room also. If the rent of room per day is 1000 or more, then taxable. That means exempt up to 999. And here I told you, in sometime in temples, inside the temple premises there will be some shops. Alright, the shops are paying rent to that temple. Alright, so that rent, if it is 10,000 or more per day, then it is taxable. That means up to 9,999 per month is exempt. Am I clear? So this is how we have discussed here. Then I told you some religious pilgrimage is there, that Hajj, and then one more was that there from Uttarakhand. Alright, so those certain activities, some religious pilgrimage is exempt. And then I told you, if I am going to teach you or train you for some recreational activities in relation to art, culture and sport. But that activity must be conducted by charitable entities, then it is exempt. How to find it in your module? This is entry number 80. So there are entries. Okay, this is there on entry number 80, and because it is spreaded here and there, we have started making handwritten notes, okay, to bring it in one place. Hello, because it is scattered, it is very difficult to follow them. So we are going to write notes on it, that is for sure. Okay, I'm just teaching you now, right? So this is how we have discussed this charitable institution activities. Allow me to go to the next one. One example is there in our module, Bhagyavati Foundation. Look at the name. By looking at name only, you can understand it is charitable. Okay. A charitable trust registered under Section 12(a) of Income Tax Act has organized meditation camp for the old age people. Yes or no? Yes. Meditation camp for old age people. So some charitable activity they are conducting, some religious activity they are conducting. GST would be exempted. Yes or no? So no GST on that. Because even yoga is a meditation. Yoga is a part of charitable activities. It is covered under definition of charitable activity. Ramnath Joshi, a priest, charges 12,000 rupees for conducting religious ceremony of birthday of Ghanshyam's son. So some birth ceremony is performed and for him, he charging. He is a priest. He charging 12,000 rupees. Taxable or exempt?
Exempt.
Okay. Next. Durga Devi Trust, a religious trust registered under Section 12(a) of Income Tax Act, owns and manages temple in their locality. So there is one temple that is owned and managed by them. It rents the commercial shops located in the precinct, like Siddhivinayak temple, I said. Okay. Temple for the rent of 10,000 per month per shop. 10,000. They are exactly charging 10,000 rupees rent. Taxable or exempt?
Taxable.
10,000 is taxable. Okay. Consideration is not less than 10,000, so it is taxable, it's not exempt. Okay. Sarva Shiksha Foundation means education for all, kind of. Sarva Shiksha Foundation, education institution registered under Section 1023 CV of Income Tax Act, owns and manages Gurudwara. Okay. It rents the community hall located in precinct of the Gurudwara for a rent of 9,000 per day for marriage function. The consideration so received is exempt because it is less than 10,000. Okay. So this is how we have discussed. Now second is agriculture related services. We are not talking about farmer here. Hello. We are not talking about farmer. Farmer is already exempt. He is agriculturalist. We are talking about other people who are providing services to agriculture. Are you getting this? Service provider to agriculture. So we are not talking about agriculturalist. Farmer, it's farm product is already exempt from GST. There is no GST on farmers. Hello. But I'm talking about other people who are supplying services to farmer or agriculture. Okay. Agriculture produce, that is also exempt. So many entries are there. If you wanted to keep track on your entries, you can just follow these numbers. Entry number 24 and all for cross-checking. And already we have written this in our notebook. Alright. So you can follow either from notebook or from your CMA module. Okay. So the first one is services by way of loading, unloading, packing, storage, or warehousing of rice. By the way, rice is not an agriculture commodity. Rice is a commercial commodity. That paddy, dhan, is an agriculture commodity. But because rice is also important for us and kind of, you know, used in daily consumption, is loading, unloading. So I'm talking about service provider. I'm not talking about cultivator of rice. I'm talking about some warehouse. Okay, now warehouse is a commercial warehouse, yes or no? But I'm storing my rice there. If I store my automobile, if I store my steel product, then it is taxable. But if I store rice, on that bill he cannot charge GST, because loading, unloading, packing and storage. Okay, these wordings you need to understand. LUPSW. Okay, so this will come again and again. Loading, unloading, packing, storage, warehousing. Loading, unloading, packing, storage, warehousing of rice. So this is rice here. Okay, next, entry number 24A, services by way of warehousing of minor forest produce. Okay, so tiny forest produce, it will be there. That is also exempt. Services by way of fumigation. Can you see fumigation mean that you know, pump guy who put some kind of you know, this, what you say, some chemicals into that particular his machine, and then he just fumigate to kill some insect. All right, are you getting this? Apne Mumbai mein we are calling him dhoor wala kind of thing, you know. So that guy, okay, fumigation. But on fumigation of what? In a warehouse of agriculture produce, so that there should not be those insects. Yes or no? Alright. So these are the private companies who are providing the services, but because they are providing services for agriculture related activities, their services are exempt. Exempt means, are you getting this? They will charge consideration but not GST. Okay? They are not allowed to charge GST. Next, services relating to cultivation of plants. So if I am going to train my 10-15 articles or my employees of Gurukul, and I'm going to take contracts from nearby villages farmer, because it is very difficult to get skilled workers for farm in villages now. It's very difficult now. We don't get skilled workers, and I'm going to train my articles for cultivation and all. Okay, so we will start taking some contracts. Okay, contract for 10 days, 15 days. For 10 days, I will give you 10 articles. Okay, and some money we will charge. Say for example, 1 lakh rupees. I don't have to charge GST on that. Why? Because I am going to provide activities in relating to cultivation of plant, rearing of all life form of animal. Rearing means, you know, training, growing, okay, reproducing those, you know, helping them to reproduce. So rearing of all life form of animals, but government always take rearing of horses as a negative activity, because it is a commercial activity, hardcore commercial activity, and people like Vijay Mallya and all in this business. Hello? Okay, so this is very typical business. It is also known as stud farm. Okay, rearing of horses is also known as stud farm. Stud farm is taxable. Balance, all other animals are exempt. So whenever horse come, please understand, horse is taxable. Okay, horse activity related to horse is taxable. So they are saying cultivation of plant, rearing of all life of all life form of animals for food, fiber, fuel, raw material and other similar product or agriculture produce by way of what is the first activity that they are saying? Agriculture operation directly related to production. Agriculture operation directly related to production of any agriculture produce. So what are the activities you do in agriculture? So these are the activities that we do in agriculture. What activity? Cultivation, harvesting. This is harvesting. Yes. Hello? In Maharashtra now, harvesting has become very difficult, because these are the month when the rice is grown. Okay. But still it is raining. Yes. Because of that, what happens? The dhan falls down to the earth. It's not on plant. Are you getting this? So it is very difficult now for harvesting, okay, threshing, plant protection or testing. Now testing of what? Testing of soil or testing of water, testing of seeds. That testing they are talking about here, okay. So I'm a lab, I'm providing testing activities, but still it is exempt because it is related to agriculture produce. Supply of farm labor. Just now I was giving you example. I will have some labors with me and I will supply that for money. I will not charge GST for that. Am I clear? Yeah. Supply of farm labor. Then processes carried out in agriculture farm. Sometime after cultivation, certain activities they have to conduct on agriculture farm itself. Hello? Okay. What are those activities, sir? So it's not exhaustively. See, just like they are giving some example. Okay. You need to understand that. tending, pruning, cutting, okay? Tending, pruning, tending means, you know, some plants are grown like this and this. So tending and pruning means you cut those plants, you know. That Mali uncle, sometime he will be having that scissor in hand and he will be cutting that plants. Why? Because so that plant should grow in proper way. It should not grow in inappropriate way. Am I clear? So that is activity, cutting, harvesting, drying. You know, sometime we put this chilies and all for, chilies are green and the chili powder is red powder. So we have to dry those chilies. Yes or no? So drying, cleaning, sometime we clean. Hello? Okay? Trimming. Trimming means you understand? Okay? Sun drying, fumigating. Fumigating I already told you. Okay? Curing, salting. Salting means this is good, this is bad. Okay? Salting. Grading. Grading means this is big size, this is medium size, this is small size. This is export quality, this is Jogeshwari quality. Alright? Cooling, bulk packaging, such like operations which do not alter, this language is important, which do not alter essential characteristics of agriculture produce but make it only marketable in a primary market. So what they are saying, okay, you take mango from mango tree, you pack in the box, okay, you pack in that box and then, you know, they put like proper covering of this, of that grass, you know. So you do that much activity, that is okay, but don't process mango to some extent where it is becoming directly mango pulp or mango jam. Hello? You can provide only basic operations on farm. Only those are exempt. If you are directly making tomato, you are providing operations on tomato, the tomato is becoming tomato ketchup, then that will become taxable. Tomato should remain tomato. It should not alter its characteristics. Hello? Alright? So those activities are there. Renting and leasing of agro machinery. You know, so I have truck, tempo, tractor. Hello? So I am renting that. So I am giving it on rent. So I will be earning rent. Normally if I give my tempo and truck on higher basis, it is taxable. But if I give to agriculture operation, it is exempt. Okay? Next. I told you again, these words will come again and again. Loading, unloading, packing, storing, warehousing of agriculture produce. See, it was already here. But for rice, they have inserted another entry. What logic I told you? Rice is not a agriculture produce, because if rice was agriculture produce, it was already covered under this entry. We did not require separate entry, but rice is not an agriculture produce, rice is a commercial produce, therefore we had separate entry for rice. Am I clear? Next, agriculture extension services. So what is agriculture extension services? So running DD Kisan channel, you know that channel is there, DD Kisan. I am a teacher, okay, I usually teach taxation and all. Tomorrow or in couple of years, I wanted to teach agriculture. So I wanted to open agriculture institution, hello, where farmers son or farmers will come and they will get trained for certain agriculture operations. Am I clear? So Kisan Training Center, that name will be Kisan Training Center. Then Kisan Call Center, Kisan? Kisan Research Center, hello. So Kisan Call Center, Kisan Research Center, all these are agriculture extension service. Okay, those are exempted in law. Next. Services by any agriculture produce marketing committee, APMC. In Washi, Navi Mumbai, we are having APMC market. Okay, what is the job of APMC market? All farmers will bring their commodities to the APMC market and buyers will go to APMC market. So bringing buyer and seller together is the job of APMC market. Are they doing it for free? Answer is no, they do charge money. But they can charge money, they are not supposed to charge GST on it because it is exempted. What is government intention behind giving exemption for it? So they don't want cost of cultivation or cost of agriculture produce to shoot up. Because if they put GST on it, it will, you know, its consideration value will go up. Are you getting this? Why these commodities were exempt that we had discussed, fish and this meat and all. If I put GST, what will happen? If you buy 500 rupees chicken today, then if I put 18% GST on it, price will go up. Yes or no? The government don't want this product or these services should be under GST regime. Okay. Because it is consumed at society, by society at a large. Okay. And we are trying to give concession to both supplier as well as consumer. Okay. Ultimately, who is benefiting it? Ultimate benefit is available to consumer. Ultimate benefit is available to because if I put this under taxation, it's like if I put hospital under taxation, what will happen? All patients will suffer. Yes or no? 1 lakh rupees fees and then 18% GST. That means you have to pay 1,18,000. Therefore, the patient is already suffering and by looking at bill, he will suffer more and then he will curse central government and state government. So they are saying the okay, whole healthcare is exempt. Whole education is also exempt. Am I clear? So these are the activities, yeah?
If I purchase a chicken from a cold storage,
yeah,
is it taxable?
No. Meat is already exempt. Whole meat is exempt. Okay, any form of meat is exempt. So can I go ahead?
Yes.
Yeah? Services by of fumigating in a warehouse of agriculture produce that we had already discussed. Okay? Next. I am not doing the main cultivation activity. I am doing job work. You understand? Do you understand job work? I gave you one example previously for job work of shirt. I'm just putting buttons on it. So what am I doing? Job work. And job work is a service. Job work is a service. So carrying out an intermediate production process. So I'm not doing the final production process, but I'm doing just intermediate production process as a job work in relation to cultivation of plants and rearing of all life form of animal except rearing of horses. Okay. So that intermediate production process is also exempt. So I'm not a main cultivator. I'm supporting cultivator. Still it is exempt. Okay. Services by way of artificial insemination of livestock other than horses. I told you for reproduction system, okay, this cow should reproduce new series, yes or no? So sometime natural insemination is not possible, okay? So they take those pumps and all from bulls in injection and they inject it. So those laboratories and all there, they are doing research and that those activities are also exempt. That is artificial insemination, okay? So this is agriculture related services. We'll see some question if we have. Our institute write everything in detail again. So Moolchand has a lease out farmer Tulsidas. Farmer name is Tulsidas. A vacant land for agriculture. So in villages this happens, no? Now your parents are settled down in Mumbai. In village they are having 2 acre, 5 acre, 10 acre land. What will they do? They will give it to some local farmers for renting. Yes or no? That is renting of land. Now your father is not doing cultivation. He is giving land for cultivation. Hello? He could have given for circus. He could have given for some company. But no, he gave it for agriculture. Therefore that rent is exempt. That rent is exempt. Not taxable. Okay? It is exempt from GST. Therefore your father is not registered under GST. So these are the items they are talking in detail. Now the next one is education service, okay? Next one is education. You know, education services, there has been an amendment and because of this amendment, your module and our module will mismatch, okay? So focus on our module. Only these entries are there now, okay? Whatever entries I am going to teach, only these are applicable, okay? There were entry 67 for IM, next entry, that is deleted now, okay? If you are having that entry, then you can cut that entry, okay? So now allow me to teach this. Education very complicated in nature, okay, and at the same time it is important in nature. So education institution may come in exam, all right? So services provided by, first of all it is services provided by whom, sir? By education institution. Now education institution can provide services either to student or to faculties or to staff. So here also you can see you are having students, we are having staff and faculty. So this institution can either provide services to you as a student, me as a faculty, and there are staff. All activities provided by education institution to student, faculty and staff are exempt. Am I clear? Yeah. So this is services provided by education institution to student and faculty and staff. Now second point, 66 clause AA, clause AA, services provided by an education institution by way of conduct of entrance exam against consideration in form of entrance fees. So there was a confusion, okay? Education start after taking admission, yes or no? Education start, when education does start? After taking admission. But lot of institution, okay, like IIM and all, okay, some colleges are there, before allowing you to take admission, they take entrance test. Yes. Now we had confusion whether entrance test fees is it taxable or not taxable, because that's not providing education. We are checking whether you are eligible or not, and we are not doing it for free. We are charging some consideration, 1,000 rupees, 2,000 rupees, 5,000 rupees fees will be there. Hello? All right. So they exempted in second entry. They said okay, now entrance fees is also exempt. So as per this amendment, entrance fee is exempt.